As COVID cases climb, there are things we can do to help protect ourselves and each other besides wearing a mask and social distancing. Gina Mangieri is always investigating and gets expert guidance on going beyond the mask.
Wear a mask, wash your hands, keep your distance in public, work, and even social settings, and add this to your arsenal of weapons to fight back against COVID. If you are symptomatic or infected, immediately self-isolate. Get tested, trace your own contacts.
Everybody needs to take that social responsibility and stand up and do the right thing. That's how we stop this.
I asked the State Department of Health for guidance on what to do if infected or if you were a close contact. They gave me 5 different pages.
So you got these forms. How does a normal person know what to do, right? How do you differentiate that?
We compiled the official Department of Health and CDC guidelines and sought expert advice to draw out the most critical steps that each of us can take to turn the tide ourselves in the face of an escalating infection rate.
Don't just sit home, get tested so you know, and do it rapidly. If you've been exposed to a positive, don't wait 4 or 5 days. Get tested, talk to an experienced provider.
Say your test comes back positive. What constitutes a close contact? Someone who should also now immediately isolate. On one document, the state said a close contact is someone within 6 feet of you for 10 minutes. Another said it's 15 minutes or more. The state says they'll be correcting it to 15 minutes after always investigating, flag the inconsistencies. An important detail they told me, which is not yet on their flyer, the proximity is starting from 48 hours before the person began feeling sick until the time the patient was isolated. In most cases, a household member will be a close contact. In some cases, it may be a friend, nearby coworker, or someone in the public who interfaced long and close enough with a positive person.
There is an embarrassment, but now's not the time to be embarrassed. Call your friends, get on your phone, tell them I'm positive, and ask them and tell them to go get tested. It's a more of a ripple effect if you don't tell and numerous other employees become positive and your whole workplace gets crippled or shut down because of it.
Close contacts need to isolate 14 days from last being with the positive person. And if living with a positive person, they should fully isolate to break the cycle.
They should put the food outside their door. They should work on having that person to have external ventilation with a window open and a fan going out and take it very serious.
Public health guidance from other states helps clearly explain who is not a close contact, which is helpful for those who may worry after hearing that someone their friend hung out with is positive, but they are likely at low risk. These can be called contacts of contacts, and experts say they are generally in the clear unless the direct close contact is symptomatic or positive in their presence. And sorry to say, keep distance from your pets too.
If you're breathing on your pet or coughing on your pet and you display a respiratory droplet, that droplet, if someone comes and then hugs the dog, gets your droplet, touches that droplet, gets it on their face, touches their eyes. So that there's multiple steps before your dog or your cat or whatever animal you have is going to transmit.
Now, for all of that in-depth guidance, there are links on our website at khon2.com. But at a minimum, wear your mask, wash your hands, keep your distance. And if you come up positive, self-isolate, test, and self-trace your own contacts. Gina Mangieri, KHON2 News, always investigating.